Hey everybody, welcome to BurraTech. In this episode, we're going to be talking about the new Picard trailer and how it relates to building a successful business. All right, welcome back. So if you don't know, the trailer to the new Picard show has just launched and it is absolutely amazing. But before we talk about that, I would like you to like and subscribe to this channel. And if you really love this video, please share it. Today's featured course is how to build games in the Unreal Engine, and you can check out more of our courses down below. Remember that every dollar we get from these courses goes into building new content. It's the best way to support this channel. All right, so in this episode, we're gonna be talking about Star Trek because if you're a nerd like me, chances are you've at least watched a few episodes of Star Trek. Personally, I've seen every single Star Trek episode there is, and I've even watched the new seasons of Discovery. So this video is important for you as developers because you might be working on some major IP. And when you work on this IP, you have to treat your job and your code differently than you would, let's say, any other kind of job. The reason is that to become a successful coder, it's more than just about piling on good code. There is a lot more to it, and we're going to be diving into that in this video. So if you don't know what Star Trek is, it's a show where people go explore the galaxy on a starship. It has a huge fan base, and frankly, it has produced some pretty good movies and shows over the years. I used to watch Star Trek The Next Generation every day at 5 o'clock when I came home from school. Star Trek The Next Generation is one of the most respected TV shows ever created, and its characters have wound into the hearts of many, including my own. So Star Trek has had a ton of different shows over the years, and there has been a bunch of movies. They've also spawned a different set of movies in a different timeline in the late 2000s. Now, of course, over decades, things change, but one thing you have to remember is that Star Trek has a huge fan base. And not only does Star Trek have a huge fan base, there's certain paradigms within Star Trek that you have to account for if you're, let's say, developing IP for it, or if you want to develop a show. So a few years ago, a new Star Trek show came out called Star Trek Discovery, and it wasn't very good. I watched, again, every single episode, but I didn't like it very much. In fact, the first season was really not that good. So oftentimes, as a business, you can produce new products that your customers don't like, or, for example, the tastes change. And you have to realize this as soon as humanly possible, because with the season one of Star Trek Discovery, it wasn't very good, and it definitely wasn't in tune with what the Star Trek franchise was about. So luckily, in this day and age, you can actually figure out what your customers want because they'll be talking online. And that's exactly what CBS did when it came to the new Star Trek shows. In fact, this is such a good example of listening to your customers that I just had to make a video about it. So season one wasn't very good, and a lot of criticism was posted online. And it seems like the creators actually looked at season one and they said, okay, let's change what they don't like about season one and put it into season two. And season two was a lot better. Still, it wasn't as good as the old Trek, but it was still better than the first season. In fact, at the same time, there was another show called The Orville, which was created by Family Guy writer Seth MacFarlane, which is a much more closer representation of the old Star Trek Next Generation than Star Trek Discovery was. And I think CBS understood that, and they tried to make season two a little bit more like The Orville. They didn't do a very good job of it. The reason is you can't just take one show and then shoehorn a bunch of ideas that aren't organic to it. Remember, if you don't do things organically, people are gonna notice. So with fans liking The Orville more than Star Trek Discovery, CBS wanted to change that, and they have. They've listened to the fans, and they are going to release the highly anticipated Picard show. So if you don't know, Picard, being one of the show's main protagonists of Star Trek The Next Generation, is going to get a sequel. Now, when I first heard about this, I was a little bit mixed because of how Discovery was. And Discovery not being a very good show, I thought that they would absolutely ruin it. But after looking at the trailer, I am completely convinced that this show is gonna be awesome. So it goes to show you that if you actually listen to your customer base, people are gonna buy your product. So what was presented in the Picard trailer was amazing. In fact, I've looked at it maybe 3 times already, and I'm pretty impressed with what I've seen in there and what they're gonna do with the show. Now, if you don't know, there's actually a legal dispute between CBS and Paramount at this time, which I'll talk about in another video and how silly it is, but for the most part, everything looks pretty good. And the reason it looks good and I'm excited about it is because it will adhere to what Star Trek is about. Furthermore, they're going to be spinning off more content in the universe. So if you work on major IP like Star Trek or Star Wars or Marvel, you have to make your product organic to what people are going to be expecting. This has happened with Marvel as well. There were several Hulk movies, and some of those Hulk movies were not organic to the Marvel universe, and they didn't do so well. So this literally can happen to anyone at any given time, and the best example of this is the prequels to Star Wars. The first series of Star Wars was absolutely amazing, but the prequels were nowhere near as good and frankly terrible movies. So as a result, you always have to make sure you are developing content that your customer base wants. So this is the major lesson that you can take away from this Picard trailer and this whole fiasco of Star Trek Discovery, is that it's easier to make money if you are making things that people want. Now, before the Picard trailers, I saw a lot of comments online like this. Comments like, I am not going to be subscribing to CBS All Access, or I can't wait to pirate this. These are really bad if you want to run a business. Now, after these Picard trailers released, I saw the opposite. Comments like, take my money now and I'm going to subscribe to CBS All Access. This is really good because, if you know, subscriptions are really hard to sell. In fact, I'll probably subscribe to CBS All Access just for this Picard show. Now, of course, I'm a super fan, so of course they're probably going to get my money. But I think a lot of people who are on the fence will probably do it as well. So what have we learned today? Well, if you make products that people like, then people will buy it. And if you're working with decades old IP, you have to make sure that the content that you're making will make that fan base happy. Thanks for listening. If you like the Picard show or want to subscribe to CBS All Access, please let me know in the comments below. Also, be sure to like and subscribe. Today's featured course is how to build games in the Unreal Engine, so check that out in the links below. Remember that every bit of money that we get from the courses below goes into producing more content. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you in another video.
Captain?
Ha ha ha.